Honorable President, the Board of Management, the Board of Trustees and the Academic Council, I declare that the fourth annual convocation of Sumandhi Vidyapeeth, the following degrees have been conferred today. PhD in Pharmacy, MD degree in Anesthesiology, in Anatomy, in Biochemistry, in Community Medicine, in Dermatology, Venereology and Leprosy, in General Medicine, in Microbiology, in Pediatrics, in Pathology, in Microbiology, in Pharmacology, in Physiology, in Psychiatry, in Radio Diagnosis, in Respiratory Medicine and in Forensic Medicine. Master of Surgery, in General Surgery, in Obstetric and Gynecology, in Ophthalmology, in Orthopedics, in Otorhinolaryngology. Postgraduate Diploma degrees in Obstetric and Gynecology, the Radio Diagnosis, the Orthopedics, Psychiatry, Anesthesiology, Ophthalmology, Dermatology, Venereology and Leprosy, Tuberculosis and Chest Diseases, in Pediatrics, Master of Dental Surgery, in Prosthodontics and Crown and Bridge, in Oral and Maxillofacial Surgery, in Periodontology, in Conservative Dentistry and Endodontics, in Orthodontics and Dentofacial Orthopedics, in Oral Medicine and Radiology, in Public Health Dentistry, in Periodontics and Preventive Dentistry, in Oral Pathology and Microbiology. Master of Nursing, MSc in Nursing, in Pediatric Child Health Nursing, in Psychiatry Mental Health Nursing, in Medical Surgical Nursing, in Community Health Nursing, in Obstetric and Gynecological Nursing. Master of Physiotherapy, MPT, in Cardiovascular and Respiratory Sciences, in Musculoskeletal Disorders and Sports Physiotherapy, in Neurological and Psychosomatic Disorders, in Pediatrics. Master of Pharmacy, M-Pharma, in Quality Assurance, in Pharmaceutics, in Pharmacology and Clinical Research, in Pharmaceutical Analysis, and Master of Business Administration, MBA, in Healthcare, followed by Bachelor of Medicine and Bachelor of Surgery, MBBS, Bachelor of Dental Surgery, WDS, the Bachelor of Science in Nursing, BSc Nursing, the Bachelor of Pharmacy, the B-Pharmacy, the Post Basic Bachelor of Science in Nursing, that is PBBSc Nursing. So these are the degrees conferred upon by all the students today. Thank you.
Congratulations to all of you. Congratulations for today. From boys and girls, you become men and women, responsible citizens of this great India. Congratulations, for the stars in your eyes will now walk alongside. Congratulations for all the nights that you studied and all the days that you spent with your books have come to fruition. Congratulations that all the sweat that your parents spent on you have come to realize. Congratulations that you worked hard and you proved your mental. Remember, from today onwards, wherever you go, along with the name of your parents, the name of this university will walk alongside. Wherever you be, Sumandhi Vidyapeeth will be with you. So congratulations to all of you. Now I request the officiating registrar, Dr. Manoj Sathgere, to place the register of graduates before the Chancellor for his signature. Can we have a loud round of applause for having signed that? Now I request the Honorable Vice Chancellor Sumandhi Vidyapeeth, Dr. J.R. Patel, to present a brief progress report of the university.
Honorable Chancellor, Air Commodore Dr. G.D. Mehta, Honorable Chief Guest Justice K.G. Balakrishnan, former Chief Justice, Supreme Court of India, former Chairperson, NHRC, Honorable Guest of Honor, Sri T. Dilip Kumar, President, Indian Nursing Council, Honorable Guest of Honor, Dr. Mansukh Shah, President, Sponsoring Trust, Honorable Ministers of Government of Gujarat, Members of Vadodara Mahanagar Seva Sadan, Officers of Government of Gujarat and Vadodara Mahanagar Seva Sadan, Dr. Ketan Desai Sir, President-elect of World Medical Association for 2016-2017 and former President of MCI, and other esteemed invited guests, members of Sponsoring Trust, members of Board of Management, Planning and Monitoring Board, members of Finance Committee, members of Academic Council, functionaries and staff members of University and Constituent Colleges, recipient of gold medals, awards and degrees, my dear young graduate and postgraduate students, respected parents, representative of press and media, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of Sumati Vidyapit, I feel privileged in extending a hearty and cordial welcome to one and all to fourth convocation of our university. We are honored to have with us our beloved Chancellor, Air Commodore Dr. G.D. Mehta sir, to preside over this convocation. He has always been guiding, motivating and driving force for our university. Sir, we have been receiving your good support at every stage in our journey towards excellence. I welcome you, sir. It is a memorable occasion for all of us to have Honorable Justice K.G. Balakrishnan amongst us today as our chief guest. Sir, the member of Sumanti Parivar and all our invitees join with me in sharing the pleasure and expressing the gratitude of having you with us today. On behalf of all members, I would like to express my great pleasure to have presence of our Honorable Guest of Honor, Sri T. Dilip Kumar and Dr. Mansukh Shah. Ladies and gentlemen, I consider it my proud privilege to present a brief progress report of Sumanti Vidyapit. In this convocation, degrees will be awarded to a total of 429 graduates, 311 postgraduates, 3 Doctor of Philosophy. 17 university gold medals also will be awarded to the toppers of our university. Sumanti Vidyapit is a deemed to be university under Section 3 of the UGC Act 1956, is a university per excellence dedicated to community health care. It strives constantly to enhance quality, innovative education, research, publications, community services and infrastructure development. Our university is first in India to have evidence-based education system as its modus operandi in teaching and clinical practice. By this mode of education system, the research and teaching have been integrally amalgamated to ensure a collaborative environment conducive to learning and providing exposure to the best international practices and promotion to innovation and creativity. Along with successful implementation of EBS, our university has implemented evidence-generating community health intervention project, Avision Chip, which encourages students to work at community level. It includes evidence-generating exercise, hands-on training for community-based projects, and designing studies on EBM pattern. In continuation with previous 2 years, 25 projects in the group of 5 students were successfully conducted during the last year. In our campus, we have established Pharmacovigilance Center for Awareness amongst all students and faculty of medical, dental, as well as allied sciences. Our university has organized second international conference on EBS during last year. Dr. Gordon Guyatt from Canada, the person who coined the term evidence-based medicine, was our guest speaker, along with Dr. Stuart Logan from UK, Dr. Regina Kunz from Switzerland, Dr. Kameshwar Prasad from AIIMS Delhi, Dr. R.V. Subramaniam from Vizag, and Dr. Gurinder Wadhwa from UK. We have also established education unit for teachers training program in all constituent colleges. I would like to present little more academic excellence of our university. We have introduced continuous cumulative evaluation system in all constituent colleges. Our university understands the need of nurturing the young minds and therefore has introduced mentorship program to lead the students toward academic excellence. We also conduct an exhaustive orientation program for both UG and PG students, which gives them insight into what lays ahead them in research and EBS apart from the regular prescribed curriculum. We have proposed implementation of EBS on a similar model in the dental colleges across the country in a phase-wise manner to Dental Council of India, and we are hopeful to have our university as a nodal center for the same. The Sumandhi Vidyapeeth has articulated and translated in earnest manner the observation of the University Education Commission 1948-49 that the libraries are the heart of the university activity. Our learning resource center is open for 24/7 and 360 days in a year. Library is fully automated and having Wi-Fi internet connectivity of 1 Gbps. Its reading room are centrally air conditioned, having capacity to accommodate more than 1,000 students at a time. Library large resource complemented with e-books, e-journals, virtual library and video library, which is accessible across the globe. The university supports the research activities in all level from student to faculty by establishing a state-of-art, well-equipped central research lab, establishing a fully functioning research cell, giving incentive to promote research by facilitating conference participation for presentation of research work, publication of the research work, and conducting the clinical research. We are also promoting faculty on higher post on the basis of research and publications. Quality research is achieved through DCGI registered SV Institutional Ethics Committee, 6 human research review panels, Institutional Animal Ethics Committee, and a stout research policy. During the last 1 year, total fund of rupees 3 crores has been allocated for the original research under SV research funding scheme. Various community research health projects were conducted through research cell during last year. Our vision ahead in research is to further augment our partnership with universities in India and abroad, will an aim to enhance the quality research and research related academic activities. Also to offer research fellowships and short-term research programs funded by the university for inspiring research as a career. With the efforts of our editorial board, Journal of Integrated Health Science, an index journal in a print and electronic media format is being published and circulated to all health universities and medical, dental, physiotherapy, nursing, pharmacy colleges of India. Our activities are reported through our website, EBS newsletter, as well as Pharma Horizon. We have published books on different evidence-based treatment protocols for all discipline. 132 research and 179 publications in index journals were to the credit of our university only during last 1 year, in addition to our previous 892 total publications. University has constantly upgraded in all its aspects of providing the best community health care. Dheeraj Super Speciality Hospital is well equipped with all ultra-modern healthcare instruments. It is 1,276-bedded tertiary care super speciality hospital where many state-of-art services are available. To continuously promote excellent care to patients, we are conducting regular free checkup and treatment camps for all disciplines at the hospital as well as community level. During camps, the beneficiaries are given free treatment. Most of the regular medical and dental services, though highly sophisticated, are provided either free or at a very subsidized and affordable cost. Last year, our hospital has conducted 245 health checkup camps where 22,541 patients were examined and treated. 7 blood donation camps were organized. First time in Gujarat, we have started free denture camp in tribal areas for needy patients. Our university has taken up many community health programs initiated by our dynamic Honorable Prime Minister of India, like Mukhyamantri Amrutam Yojana, Chiranjeevi Yojana, Balsakha Yojana, Rashtriya Swastha Bima Yojana, Swastha Vatsalya Yojana, Healthy Mother to Healthy Child, Suraksha Setu Program, Health Checkup for Police and their family members, and many more programs. Our vision ahead in community services is to develop state-of-art affordable treatment centers in the field of oncology, emergency medicine, family medicine, gastroenterology, and many more, in addition to our existing super specialty services like cardiology, cardiothoracic, neurology, nephrology, and plastic surgery. Major augmentations in infrastructure are an additional well-furnished hall of residence, which has increased to the capacity of 2,500 accommodation in total, a state-of-art, a sport complex with internationally accepted norms, a convention center for conducting national and international events. We are on the way to establish a sport academy with nationally acclaimed professionals. We work to ignite the spark in young minds to make them lifelong self-learners and good human beings. Thank you for your patience listening. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. Now it's my proud privilege and singular honor to give a brief introduction about the chief guest. But I will be failing in my duty if I do not speak a few words about our guest of honors before I invite the chief guest for his convention address. The guest of honor today, Sri T. Dilip Kumar, President, Indian Nursing Council, Project Director, GFATM Program, and ex-nursing advisor to the Government of India, is a doyen in the field of nursing. He was also a member of Global Advisory Group of Nursing and Midwifery of WHO. He was the first nursing professional from India to become the member of the Global Advisory Committee to WHO. He has worked very hard in upgrading the schools of nursing into colleges of nursing and in establishing quality assurance models in nursing and various other improvements. While working as nursing advisor to Government of India, he was instrumental in increasing the allocation from rupees 80 crore in the 10th plan to rupees 3,200 crore in the 11th plan for nursing sector. He is also responsible for obtaining global funding from GFATM to the Indian Nursing Council to the tune of 160 crores. So, ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for the guest of honor, Sri T. Kumar. Our next guest of honor is Dr. Mansukh Bhai Shah, President, Sumandeep Vidyapeeth Trust. He is a father figure, and one does not describe a father in words. It can only be described in emotions. So, sir, all our emotions, and we thank you for what you are and where you are. A loud round of applause for the President. And now, as I said, it's my singular honor to describe somebody who is virtually undescribable. To put in words somebody's life, whose life spans over all limitations and restrictions, whose life is a symbol of breaking the shackles of limitations and reaching the highest levels. Honorable Justice K.G. Balakrishnan, former Chief Justice of India and former Chairperson of NHRC, starting a life with humble beginnings, starting from margins and coming into the mainstream, a childhood in a distant village of Kerala, and then rising to the highest echelons of power in Lutyens, Delhi. Someone probably affected by social injustice, rising to acquire the highest seat of justice in the country. Ladies and gentlemen, that's in short Justice K.G. Balakrishnan. A legal luminary, starting his life from Kerala, moving on to Gujarat. Can you believe it? He has not only been the Chief Justice of Gujarat High Court, but also been acting governor of the state. And therefore, sir, how do I say welcome to you? How do I welcome you to the state of Narmada and Sabarmati? How do I welcome you to the state of Gir, Somnath and Dwarka? How do I welcome you to the state of Navaratri and Garwa? How do I welcome you to the land of the Mahatma, Vallabhbhai Patel, Morarji Desai, and of course, presently our dynamic Prime Minister, Narendra Bhai Modi? How do I welcome you to this sleepy village of Piparia? How do I welcome you to Vadodara, the seat of power of the erstwhile Gaikwads and the center of culture of Gujarat? How do I welcome you to this university which has given the first lady president of the Medical Council of India? How do I welcome you, sir? Because I know that you know Gujarat better than me. Gujarat belongs to you because you have been a part of the legal system of the state. And therefore, with the greatest of respect and the profoundest of feelings that one can put in words, I would like to invite you, but I would also like to say, it's very difficult to request a justice of the Supreme Court to pass his judgment. But sir, each word that you utter here today is going to be a judgment for us, and we shall accept it with grace and with bowed heads. May I request you, sir, for your convocation address?
Chancellor of this university, Air Commodore Dr. G.D. Mehta, Vice Chancellor of this university, Dr. J.R. Patel, other distinguished guests, professors, doctors, ministers, judges, all other distinguished guests who are on the dais, members of the faculty of this prestigious university, various faculties, professors, lecturers, members of the other teaching staff, and the students, their parents, and other distinguished guests. I feel extremely delighted to be in Gujarat. For me, it is a homecoming. I spent some of my beautiful years in Gujarat. And I am particularly delightful to be present today at the fourth convocation ceremony of Sumandip Vidyapeeth, a university which through unstinted efforts and dedication of its president, chancellor, vice chancellor, principal, faculty, staff, and vibrant contribution of its students, has earned the honor of being regarded among the premier institutions of higher learning in medicine, healthcare, management in the country today. At a time when one witnesses a rush among students to move to limited metropolitan cities, a study in the universities situated there, it is heartening to note Sumandip Vidyapeeth is attracting students and excellent faculty members from across the country. With its world-class infrastructure, state-of-the-art academic and residential facilities, and wide exposure for students, I hope the university will further expand its ambit of higher education and its reach among students across the country and the world. I would like to commend Sumandip Vidyapeeth for its university song. I had occasion to go through it, which seeks to imbibe the students a deep sense of respect for our traditional cultural values, which always held knowledge, and compassionate service to all humanity in the highest pedestal. It is rare indeed to find in today's time universities which have devoted time and effort in developing their university song which reflects their core values and vision for the future. The convocation ceremony is an opportune moment for faculty and students alike to celebrate the achievements of the past and look towards the future. This ceremony marks the conclusion of the journey of yet another batch of students of this university who I am sure are filled with a sense of deep nostalgia and appreciation for the precious years spent at their alma mater. The joy and exhilaration which is seen on the face of each one of you is palpable in this evening, having gone through the rigors of academic life and other non-academic pursuits, including the building of precious relationship with their batchmates, seniors, juniors, and the faculty staff at the university. The graduating students have fulfilled their long-cherished dreams, are now ready to take on higher, greater challenges beyond the protective environs of their university. I congratulate all of you on your success and urge you to make fullest use of your latent potential and not only build valuable lives for yourself, but also dedicate your energies in the service of other noble pursuits, such as contributing meaningfully to the achieve the marginalized and the voiceless. It is my fervent hope that young and passionate men and women, you will commit yourselves to contribute more significantly to the amelioration of the problems facing humankind and those disadvantaged sections of society. The knowledge that you have acquired during the course of your education in this university will hold you good stead in the years ahead and will become source of immense and unparalleled confidence in your respective chosen fields, work and future study and research. Students' life offers wonderful opportunity for you to discover your distinct ability and strength, whether through academic or extracurricular pursuit. When you strive to do your best in whatever task it is, yea, you set in motion in process of self-discovery and become aware of your own unique capacities as individuals and teammates. In today's competitive age, it is important for institutions of higher learning to meet aspirations today's generations of youth and provide them with academic learning, especially in the field of medical care. We are, especially in the rural area, we cannot claim that we are giving the best medical facilities. Our country is supported by the private health care to a great extent. As per the World Health Organization, 2.2% of the GDP should spend on health and health education. But we are not spending that much money by our government for the health, and we are not able to control many of the illness which is spreading, and we have got serious problems in the regard health care. I firmly believe this can be achieved by a regular review of the curriculum as to make comparable those in the best and most sought after universities, not only in India but across the globe. This is extremely essential considering the rapid social, economic, political, cultural and technological changes that are taking place in the present times. At the same time, I believe that an educational institution must ingrain in the student's sense of humility. Humility teaches us to appreciate others, enables us to acknowledge that there can be a number of equally valid approaches to meet the same objective. Today, the university's alumni are making their mark as achievers and leaders in various spheres of activity, including medicine, dentistry, pharmacy, physiotherapy, nursing, MBA healthcare, management, as well as higher academic research, bringing home laurels, of which I am certain the university is very proud. The right to health is today recognized as a fundamental right of every human being and includes access to timely, acceptable and affordable health care appropriate quality. While India has undertaken several measures to strengthen the access to health care, unfortunately, access to affordable and quality health care in the country remains far from achieved. Deficiencies in rural health care availability are further exacerbated by a lack of diagnostic facilities, doctors, and adequate free essential medicines. Ability is in the context that the role of universities and institutions, specialized learning such as Sumandhi Vidyapeeth must be viewed. The role of not only providing knowledge and skills to its students, but also encouraging them to actively work towards bridging the gap in the crucial sector of healthcare, especially for the most vulnerable sections of our population. The renowned Japanese educator said, a goal of education must be value creation, both in life of the individual and through the individual society at large. The ambit of higher education, therefore, must be broadened to create such value. An important consideration in conferring the higher education system will have to be making accessible to all sections of Indian society, thus bridging the urban, rural, gender and other divides. We must endeavor that our education system is judged not merely by the number of degree holders, but in large number the informed citizens that we create. Enlightened citizens, we respect human values and instinctively rise above narrow feeling. Thus, it is important for institutions of higher learning to introspect and constantly assess the contribution that they are making, not only raise the scholastic abilities of the students, but also the development of human values. It is only through such concerted efforts that universities can live up to their lofty missions, being institutions of learning which are driven by values. I take this opportunity to once again congratulate the faculty and staff of the Sumandhi Vidyapeeth for their efforts not only impart education to the students, but also for contributing their all-round development. The sense of confidence, the optimism evident among the students of this graduating batch will be immensely useful as they embark on new journey in their lives. Let me conclude with the following quote by the Buddhist philosopher Dzogchen Ikeda. I quote, "Greatness as a human being is not determined by educational backgrounds or social position. A truly great person is one who can be a friend to those in suffering, pain and misery," unquote. The future of humanity, therefore, will depend on the ability and commitment of our education to foster capable and human world leaders and make this century remembered in history for its respect of human rights, peace and justice. I will ultimately be up to the youth, especially young women, to open the way to such a new era of brotherhood and peaceful coexistence. I once again extend my heartiest felicitations to the students and faculty of Sumandhi University on this occasion. I wish each and every student graduating today and taking postgraduate degrees and other felicitation the very best on all future endeavors, and wish the university continued success and growth in times to come. Thank you. Thank you very much for inviting this prestigious function.
Thank you, sir, for your profound thoughts and a speech which is going to stir our thought process for times to come. I want to thank you once again by quoting from what you said once on having achieved the highest seat of office. And you said, I quote, "Really, it's a matter of pride for us, but what I achieved is the result of hard labor and integrity," unquote. That's what life is all about. That's what all students here should be trying to achieve. I also take this opportunity to welcome Dr. Hitendra Patel, Chairman, Standing Committee of Vadodara Mahanagar Seva Sadan. Thank you, sir, for being with us. I also take this opportunity to apologize if I have missed any names which I am not able to see from here very clearly. So welcome once again to all of you who are here. Now, going to the next part, which is the most important part of a convocation. I now request the officiating registrar to announce the names of students who have acquired gold medals through their hard work. Officiating registrar, please.
With the grace conferred upon all of us today, I take the privilege of announcing the names of the students for gold medals. And I request our Honorable Chief Guest, Justice K.G. Balakrishnan sir, to give away the gold medals. Sri Manjibhai Banaji Bhai Shah Memorial Gold Medal goes to, for the year 2015, has been awarded to Dr. Patel Chintan Labu Bhai, student of Srimati B.K. Shah Medical Institute and Research Center, the Faculty of Medicine, who has passed the MBBS examination at the first attempt, obtaining the highest percentage of marks during the year 2014. Patel Chintan. For the year 2015, has been awarded to Dr. Parik Vibhuti Vijay, student of Srimati B.K. Shah Medical Institute and Research Center, the Faculty of Medicine, who has passed the MBBS examination at the first attempt, obtaining the highest percentage of marks in the year 2015.
Let the applause continue. How can you be silent when somebody is receiving the best reward for all the hard work here?
I now announce Srimati Hirama Manjibhai Shah Memorial Gold Medal has been awarded to Dr. Shah Harsh Kumar Sanjay Kumar, student of KM Shah Dental College and Hospital, the Faculty of Dentistry, who has passed the BDS examination at the first attempt, obtaining the highest percentage of marks during the year 2014. I now announce late Sri Amritlal Kanjibhai Shah Memorial Gold Medal has been awarded to Ms. Patel Riya Yogesh Kumar, student of College of Physiotherapy, the Faculty of Allied Sciences, who has passed the BPT examination at the first attempt, obtaining the highest percentage of marks during the year 2014. Patel Riya, please. Thank you, sir. I now request our guest of honor, Mr. Dilip Kumar, sir, to award the gold medals. I now announce Srimati Bikiben Kanjibhai Shah Memorial Gold Medal has been awarded to Ms. Patel Megaben Gitesh Bhai, student of Sumandeep Nursing College, the Faculty of Allied Sciences, who has passed the BSc Nursing examination at the first attempt, obtaining highest percentage of marks in the year 2014. I now announce Sumandeep Vidyapeeth University for Gold Medal has been awarded to